Green is a color of nature. Green is a color that helps alleviate anxiety, depression, nervousness. Green also brings with it a sense of hope, health, adventure, and self-control. Today, I'll be taking you to Kenanfell Park. This is the park's main entrance with four statues standing tall, a water fountain before entering. On entering, there is a small cave. The park is 10 hectares in area, largest park in the Swiss city of Basel, built in the year 1951. You could see lots of greenery with huge trees and relaxing points. Currently, this park now hosts walkers, joggers, children play area, a small amphitheater, table tennis point, fountains, architecture. You could see people doing a barbecue. There are just few rules to follow when you do a grill party in the park. Always keep grill tray at least 30 cm from the floor. Keep distance of 2 meters from tree leaves. Ensure smoke does not disturb park visitors. Once the ashes cool down, dispose them carefully. The park also has prefixed barbecue stands. You can just bring the charcoal and grill veggies and meat here. A small birthday party celebrated at one end. It looked so cute and colorful. People making their own picnic spots. Huge trees around the park. Trees here in the park are relocated from around the world. You could see different species of trees. This is the fun side of the park. Like they say, a coin has two sides. The park does. I was surprised upon entering the rear entrance of the park. It was not like walking into a normal park. I began to realize it was more than a park and read its history. It's formerly a cemetery until 1932. Also, like I said earlier, this park has 180 species of trees. Some trees had name boards on them, and some trees were like mystery tall, strong, old trees which were unnamed. This tree is a Chinese parasol tree in Kenanfell Park, planted on November 19, 2016 and baptized as a tree of poetry. If you are a poetry lover, do visit. Some of the graves were relocated, such as that of poet pastor Jonas Breitenstein. In addition to the mighty entrance which we had seen in the beginning, the enclosure wall, some monuments remain here, though now it is converted to a park. Let's see few of them. The tomb. This monument is built in the memory for the dead of the Great War. These are not relocated and still remain here, though it is converted to a park now. On further walking, came across a giant peeping out from a tree. This is the giant tree monster. I heard we should be careful with it. So be careful when you visit. I was happily clicking pictures and posing in front of all the mystery looking elements in the park, not knowing its history. Coming back, I read its history and came to know this was a cemetery turned into a park and got a slight thrill. Next time, I would definitely be careful. I don't want to end the video by showing the mystery elements. I wanted to show you the fun side again, taking you to a music concert in the amphitheater from the band. Now the kids play area. This looked more like the Takeshi's castle that comes in Pogo when we were kids. I enjoyed watching them for a while. Then the normal slides. Another popular attraction is a paddling pool that is also used as a skate park on other seasons. Kids having fun. Another species of tree spotted. This looked unique too. I hope you loved watching this video, seeing different species of trees relocated from around the world and knowing how a cemetery turned into a park looked. This park is a perfect place to spend your summer and spring, very peaceful and pleasant with all the greenery around you. Thanks for spending time with me, and please don't forget to subscribe.